Steve Denny here, and we live here in Brooklyn, Chicago. We're in the southeastern suburbs, and it's called Ireland Park, Orland Park. And where we are right now, and now we're in, when I was growing up in high school, they called it Death Row, Red Dress and Rain, and all kinds of different names that they called it, but the legendary high school was up here in Compton, and you'd go there, and there's a pond back there you can see, and again, you know when this movie, the weird, weird stuff that happened back there. It was very legendary. The biggest thing to do was on October 31st, Halloween, come back. And now the police kind of smart enough that they blocked off the area. You can't even drive on the main street right here, 1043rd Street, a major street in Chicago area.
Every Halloween.
They have people patrolling things on the way you can't get in. It's such a legend. Now, 10 years ago, we used to sneak back to these woods and just come in and see things. When I came back there, we didn't see much. But, you know, again, like you said, sometimes you see things, sometimes you don't.
That's right. Now, this is supposedly where this legend of Resurrection Mary started.
Correct.
And this is a lady who actually hitchhikes.
She hitchhikes, right?
And she actually gets in people's cars.
Right.
And when people pick her up, she usually gives them an address or something, tells them where she wants to be taken home or something.
Unfortunately, came through the story came through the high school there, you know, stories were five different ways. And as you're telling me the story, it's kind of what I remember too, but basically, what version there, if I remember correctly, we were all white, right? And the big thing was hitchhikers. You know, she took hitchhiker and she disappears.
Right.
And,
I heard the story that one guy picked her up in the rain, and, I guess he was wearing like a petticoat, like a palm dress, like she's coming back from the palm or something. And she got in the car, and what happened was she looked so wet and uncomfortable. He put his jacket on her. She's in the car, so she gave him the address, and he took her home, and he pulled out, of course, as the old story goes, she disappeared. And he went up to the house, meets up with an elderly couple who turned out to be people who explained that the description of this woman matched the description of their daughter who died in a car accident,
right?
Did you hear too?
Well, not necessarily the same story, but yeah. The resident that she died in the car accident.
Yeah.
Always the same story, right?
And it was a little twisted because the next day, this really got to him. So the next day, he goes back to the cemetery, I guess we're about to see. He looks and finds her name. I don't know what her name was. So Mary, we don't know her last name. And he finds her exact tombstone. Draped across the tombstone is that jacket.
And there's some to that effect. Again, the story probably changed a little since I heard it. Of course, it was a little more dramatic when I heard it.
Yeah,
I'm not sure if you guys would have heard
it. But now we're going to go see. This is,
you know, quite honestly, I mean, I've heard about this place for many, many years, and like I told you, I've never once before, and I was, you know, my high school years, and I, you know, really wanted to have some fun. This was more of an adventure. Instead of trying to feed the curiosity, it was more of an adventure. And so I really remember my experience being able to this day, people still talk. And it's funny, because, you know, I get together with people, I get some tape, and I don't do anything, and somehow we get a subject about this place. And you're from LA, you know what I'm saying? Imagine how it is someone that lives the next time over. I went to high school with.
Yeah.
Who already knows the story, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It comes up in a minute. I just remember back during those years, 16, 17, 18, 18. This was the place, you know, this was the place that when we were putting the camera all together and seeing that the police came out and real slow radioing in, they watched this place really, really carefully. They watch it now, from what I understand, because of the bandits. You know, they're trying to destroy things and take things. But the legend of this place is, I'm kind of excited to see what's going to be like myself. But I did hear
it's kind of real quick.
I didn't know it's kind of a long walk.
Okay. Does it look pretty good, kind of thing?
Yeah. We did a little iris and we walked in out of shade.
Yeah, it looks like they have this place all fenced in now at this point, don't they?
Yeah, they were.
Say that again?
Unfortunately, now it's more of a party atmosphere, you know, and I guess I was a victim of that when I was 15, but you can see all the beer cans. So the police protect it now for the sake of the cemetery, the people resting here. So I think, see, there's a pond right back there. That's the pond that people say they see a lot of. The pond is really what I hear a lot of things about, saying, oh, this happened at the pond. That, you know, this, that you don't know what she was not sure. Bodies fly out of the pond, things fly out of, you know, sparks, or, you know, all kinds of stuff.